Making explosion boxes super fun, and here is my quick tutorial on how to make super easy explosion boxes. Hi friends, it's Sonia here and let's get started with the tutorial. For my base, I am going to have this white color cardstock and I'm going to score 9 inches by 9 inches and divide it into 3 equal parts. So here I get a 3 inch by 3 inch flap on each side. Now I'll cut the extra paper. Now this is how my base looks, and I'm going to cut it only from one side just to give it a nice fold when I'm closing up my box. Now I'm going to just give it a nice fold along my scored line so that it's easy for me to fold and arrange my box. Now it's time to use your beautiful pattern paper. So here I have taken one of my favorite pattern paper and it's from Bob and Betty, and I'm going to cut a little smaller size than 3 inches by 3 inches, and I'm going to have total 16 pieces of this. Now I'm going to stick all these 16 pieces on the back and the front side of my explosion box to removing the center pieces. And here I'm using my Fevicol to stick these beautiful pattern papers. I'm not at all following any particular way or pattern of sticking these floral papers, as anyways which way they look really beautiful, and I just want to go with the color combination of white and pink and peach. So I am not at all following any particular way or pattern of sticking these papers. Now once I'm done with the sticking of the front and back of the pattern paper, now I will be scoring my second layer of the explosion box. Now for this one, I'm making a smaller block as the second layer has to be a little smaller. So here I'm scoring 2.5 inches block of each. So in total it's 7.5 by 7.5 inch square. Now for the second layer, I am going to cut all the corner squares and make it a typical explosion box base. So this is how your base looks, and I'm going to use again a piece of pattern paper from the same paper pack, and I'm going to stick it only on the top layer of my second layer card. Usually I prefer to use my tacky tape for my explosion boxes and my scrapbooking, but for while making a video I always try to use Fevicol, at its a super easy and takes a little less time, cause with the tacky tape you need to stick it, then peel it off and then stick it. So I find Fevicol a little easy and speedy to work with. So this is how my layers are going to look. Now on the back side of the second layer, I am going to use my pink color ink pad and my one of my favorite background stamp from Crafty Scrappers, and I'm going to stamp it on the back side of the second layer. With any of the background stamps like this one I have, I really can play along with the design. Like, and I can have butterflies somewhere, the sentiment somewhere, and they are really nice to mix and match. Now with the leftover pieces of my second flap, I am going to make my third layer, and for this I'm not like going for any particular size. I'm just marking it with my scoring tool and I'm going to score it, cut the extra part, and it's ready to use. So here my flaps are ready, and now I'm going to stamp the same background stamp on the top layer of my third flap. The third flap is already so teeny mini, so you're not going to see the back side of it, so I'm not doing anything on the back side. Just cut it, stamp it and stick it, and it's ready. Now for the lid of my explosion box, I have taken a leftover cardstock piece, and the box size is 3 by 3 by 3 inches, so I'm going to score 3 inches by 3 inches and then I'm going to leave a border of 1 inch. Now just to let my lid open easily and does not stuck with my pattern paper, I'm just scoring one extra line outside the 3 inches and I'm going to cut it along the lines. I always prefer to do most of the cutting work with my scissor so that it's easy to speed up your process of cutting. This really helps in your fussy cutting work. Over the time when you cut more with your scissor, you are really easy and you are super fast with your fussy cutting, and this gives you a very good hand and eye coordination, and which really helps in fussy cutting. So now I'm just going to fold the sides of my lid, and I'm going to strip the pattern paper from the same paper pack and cut the extra pieces. Now once I'm done with the sticking work, here is I'm again using the same background stamp and doing the stamping on the top part of the lid. Usually I prefer to do all the sticking and stamping work before sticking the sides of the lid so that it's easy to work. Now once I'm done with the sticking and folding, so this is how my cap looks. Now this is one of my favorite part where you actually assemble all your explosion box. So here I'm using my glue drops to stick the second layer and third layer of my explosion box, and this is how the closed box looks like. So here I am using a leftover foam tape roll and to give it a nice 3D effect to my floral arrangement which I'm going to do at the center. So I've stick it with the Fevicol and on the top of it I'm going to use my floral arrangement. As my pattern paper and my color combination goes, this floral arrangement was a perfect combination for me and I really did not have to use any other embellishment for this. You can always do the embellishment work and the detailing work as per your theme, your pattern paper, your color combination and the occasion when you where you have to give this. One of my quick tip while doing the assembling work of the explosion box, it's better to use Fevicol. It takes a little time to dry, but then it's very easy to twist and turn your flowers and the embellishment so that when you close the box, you know that where it is going to be. Now it's time to decorate the lid, and here I have some of the cutest flowers, my handmade sentiment, and I'm going to stick it with my glue drop, Fevicol, and I'm going to use cotton thread, my dry leaf and decorate it. So this was my take on making the explosion box in a very simple and fast way. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any queries, please do comment below and I'll be listing all the supplies in the comment box. Do check that. Thank you so much for watching.